baby. I'll be stuck to you like glue, baby. Wanna spend it all on you, baby. My room is the G spot. Call me Mr. Flintstone. I can make your bed rock. I can make your bed rock. I can make your bed rock, girl.
First weekend vlog. I'm excited about it. Right now I'm getting ready to film a boohoo haul. I'm not filming the whole thing right now, just half of the haul. It's gonna be a really big haul, so I hope you all enjoy it. Today C and I have a pretty busy day. We are having a day date. We're doing roller skating today. I haven't really shared this much on social media, but C and I started roller skating in August, and we've been going every Saturday to this roller skating rink in Maryland, and it's been a lot of fun. But recently C found an instructor who does like a skating clinic every Saturday, which is like really like a block from our house. So we're like, okay, instead of like trekking over to Maryland, let's see what's good with this skating clinic. C went last weekend and I didn't go because unfortunately I was still under quarantine. That's another story. I don't have COVID, but someone else I was around tested positive, so I had a quarantine. Anyway, C really enjoyed it, so she was like, come on, let's go next week, you'll be out of quarantine. So we're gonna do that. We're also gonna go to Marshall's, so you're gonna get to shop with us for a bit. And I have some editing to do later for, actually for this wig. This wig is gonna be $20 Tuesday. This is really cute. I have it in two colors. I literally just plopped it on my head and added powder, so right now, you know, you might be able to see some of the lace right here, but that's because I didn't blend it yet. This is a super cute wig. I think you all are really gonna enjoy seeing this video. So yeah, right now, let me just get myself together, get some of this clothing haul stuff out the way, and then after that, we're all gonna go skating! Woohoo! All right, y'all, don't mind the mirror, but we are getting ready to go skating. And this is my first time really skating outdoors. So your girl had to buy some extra protection, elbow pads, knee pads. I actually have wrist guards as well. And of course, my helmet. My skates are pink, so I've been doing this whole pink thing with my skating gear. And I'm super excited. Woohoo! Y'all like my Whitney shirt? I got this from Five Below. Yeah, see, and I got this shirt. And these shorts are from Amazon. These are hands down my favorite shorts that I got this summer. They're stretchy, they're comfortable. I'm wearing a size extra large. Ooh, I look so cute to go skating. Let me know in the comments if y'all are into roller skating, whether you used to do it back in the day, or maybe you picked it up during the pandemic, the quarantine, whatever. We literally just started in August. Last time I skated was probably like 5 or 6 years ago. And I was okay back then, but I'm trying to make something shake, you know what I'm saying? So let me know if y'all are here for the roll bounce tease.
We are running a little late. This girl is prepared and ready.
Yes,
to certainly. Not to be safe on our walk.
Yes,
you realize you don't have your skates on.
I know.
Oh shit, I hit the phone button.
So, oh, you are Vicky.
You ready to go?
Yes, ma'am. I'm ready to go. Ready to skate outside. Woohoo!
On the cement. First time ever. Let's see how this goes.
This just reminds me of back in the day when going to ride my bike.
You wore pads?
Mm-hmm.
Of course you did.
Yeah. I was a kid. I was so
tight. I didn't wear pads. I don't think I own pads.
Really?
Yeah. Or a helmet.
What do you mean you have a helmet?
Where we get a helmet from?
The store?
Mm-hmm. Who got helmet money?
It's forgetting, man.
We are here. Let's see if I see anybody. Maybe I got the wrong weekend.
See, be quiet.
I don't see anybody.
There's one person.
That person has a mask on, but they're there. I see them. Hey, morning. Hey, how's it going? Good. Hey, how's it going?
Getting ready.
Yes, I'm almost ready.
And
I'm a bow, a spy.
All black, everything.
You know how to do. Right, exactly. Like, that's exactly.
It's a very glamorous waiver. It's actually four pages. The first two pages are pretty straightforward. Skating and COVID. And then the last two pages are from the Salvation Army. The Salvation Army doesn't know what to do with us, so they gave us this generic pandemic waiver. And it's got stuff on it like, you can carry 200 pounds, you can skate, you can stand for 12 hours a day, background check, and all this crazy stuff. So all we have to do basically is nod our head for that part. You can put your name on the front and then sign on the back and then leave it all, the rest of it blank. So that's what that looks like.
Thank you for clarifying.
Welcome to the pre-learn to skate clinic. I'll be teaching you. My name's Andrew. Well, tell me your name once again. I'm sorry.
Oh, Gladys.
Gladys.
Gladys Knight. What's your name?
No, you've got, you know, when I was in high school, I had one of my best friends is Gladys.
Oh, seriously?
So, yeah.
I like your best friend incarnate.
Yeah. Taking care, we've got the wrist guards, elbow pads.
Can you make it?
Yeah.
I'm just gonna record you falling, and then I'm gonna go walk over there.
Okay.
And there I go, rolling away.
She can't turn around.
Can't stop.
You know how to stop, Gladys?
Needless to say, Andrew did have to come rescue me from running into another car. And yeah, he brought me back, and we continued the lesson.
So that's one of the things that we specialize in, right? We'll teach you like how to be really comfortable in the parking lot, you know? With this parking lot, this is like the perfect parking lot because it's like boot camp for parking lots, you know? It's got all these little hills that you would never find on a rink. As an outdoor school, we'll teach about how to handle all those things, right?
Right.
Yeah, so that's what we're all about. So some people are all about jam skating and something like that.
What's jam skating?
Street skating.
Oh.
We're all about street skating.
Oh, street skaters?
And trail skating too, yeah.
That's what I'm trying to get up to.
Wow. You're on your way, my friend.
I'm getting there, yeah.
I'm
getting there. Yeah, I'll be all in the streets.
Awesome. I'm trying to be for the streets too.
No, not yet. You got to get let's see you for the carpet for right now.
Okay.
All right.
Carpet to streets.
You know? You go. Exactly. This carpet literally like will help you get ready to get on the street.
You see, I'm not moving, right?
And you feel like you can't, but you can. Watch, you'll see. You'll see.
You're magically not moving. You are like not moving in a good way. Like you're not rolling away. It's not like I'm talking to you and I'm like, Gladys, this is what we're gonna do. And like you're kind of rolling. None of that is happening because you're on the carpet.
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing. Thank God.
Let's get back to our falling. Here, I'll do it on this side. So then.
Yeah. He does it really cool.
So here, Andrew was teaching me how to fall properly. Basically, he said you have to lean forward towards your knees and basically go onto your knees, right? Placing your hands down first and then putting your knees down next. Andrew's a really good teacher and he made the process very easy to understand.
You were awesome.
Thank you.
All right, so here's the second part.
Okay.
So this is me falling all the way to the ground, you know, and I'm gonna kind of stretch out. And it's also not quite a dive, but something like that.
So during this part of the lesson, Andrew showed me how to dive into the floor when I'm trying to fall. It's important to learn how to fall properly so that you don't seriously injure yourself. So I really appreciated this lesson because your girl never learned how to fall. I would just like probably stop, drop, and roll or something. I don't know. But this seems to be a safer option.
And so I kind of put one knee forward. I put my hand on my knee. And then I use my toe stop to kind of push myself up. And I do a little grunting along the way. And then I'm up. You can do the same thing.
You gotta have them. Oh, your toe stop came off. You gotta do the lace. It's gonna mess up. Yeah.
Oh, you're too good.
That's how to fall. Okay.
Yay, so we fell successfully.
Woo. Good job, Gwladys.
How do you do this in the moment? Like, how do you remember in that, like, minute?
That's a good question to ask, and I'm really glad you asked that because it's the perfect question for the rest of the stuff I'm going to talk about. So the check is in the mail. With your hands forward, you can kind of keep an eye on them, and it's basically really easy to remember. Oh no, go low. And what you do is you bend your knees and put your hands on your knees. Yeah, and what this does is it lowers your center of gravity. So you have a chance to recover from that sensation that you've lost balance. Right?
Okay. That's a good one. Oh no, go low. Okay. Oh no, go low. Yeah.
So it's like you're skating around and you're like, I'm gonna fall.
Oh no, go low. Oh no, go low.
Start falling. You can't really predict or feel exactly how you're gonna fall, but this will kind of help you, you know, work on falling on the right direction.
Okay. All right, I like that.
So after we practiced falling, we did what Andrew calls skate yoga, where you're basically balancing, stretching, moving your body on your skates, because that's what a lot of skating is, just learning how to be one with the skates, you know, because obviously it's way different from walking. So it's important to do these beginner things because it's like the foundation to actually learning how to skate well. I know it's easy to want to skip this part or not want to practice this part, but it's definitely necessary. And if any of you have ever taken like dance classes or, you know, played a sport, you know how important those foundational skills are.
And come on down over here, Gwladys, because it's a little flatter.
Yeah.
Oh.
For the newbies.
So you see this red line
yeah.
here? Set up on the fence along this red line.
I can't. I don't know what to do.
Boy, you turn your back for a second, and the whole
I legit didn't know what to do.
I'm like. You tried to help.
I did. It was a waiver, and I'm like, but don't take me down.
The first tool that we're going to put in our toolbox is something called, like, the plow stop. It's called the plow stop. Well, here, first I can demo the plow stop, right? And I'm skating, and I'm going downhill, right? I'm like, oh no, I gotta slow down. That's what I do. Let's go through the steps if we can.
Okay.
So at this point, Andrew showed us the steps of doing a proper plow stop. And this is important because if you're going downhill, you need to know how to stop, and you can't always use your toe stoppers because you would probably tumble if you were going downhill. So this was helpful because I didn't even know anything about this. We struggled a little bit, but I think we all did a pretty good job. By the way, if you're interested in my skates that I really love, they're just so me. They're definitely my personality, rainbow, bright, and shiny, and happy. I'll leave a link for it in the description box down below.
Oh, I can't go backwards.
Also,
okay.
Let's try practicing that.
Okay. That's what I want to practice. Okay. Knees together. I'm about to try it right now, but that's the move I actually like doing.
Oh yeah, okay. Okay.
If Danny asks what you're doing, just tell him you're invading.
Hey girl, we're skate twins.
Yep.
I'm vlogging. I hope you don't mind being on camera. Okay.
Hey girl.
Backwards. That's the first time I ever went backwards, though.
Okay, so I'm now on the ground, you guys. I did just fall. My tush, Andrew, is here sitting with me for moral support. I'm okay, I promise. We're gonna get back up. The pain has dissipated. We're gonna do this again. We're going downhill today, okay? Okay.
So Glass is gonna attempt to do the slow down turn. If you mess this up. Toes together, there you go. Yeah! Such a supportive group.
This is so much fun. I feel like I'm learning a lot at this skating clinic. Andrew, right here, he's bomb. He's really good. I didn't get to talk too much with the other instructor, but he was also helpful when I did speak with him. So yeah, I'm on my skates. I'm on the move. I love the pink. You see my pink mask? You see my lemon? Yeah, I'm getting in such a good workout right now. The clinic is pretty much over. It's been about like an hour and 45 minutes. Normally they go for an hour, but the guys here, they're kind of just like, whenever people start dropping out, that's when we leave. So they're not too pressed about sticking to an hour, which I don't mind. And I think it's very kind of them. But yeah, we're just out here in this big old parking lot next to the Salvation Army. And the people here are really nice, the people that have attended the clinic. Okay. My bitch almost fell trying to talk to y'all. What is happening? Okay, I'm back. Ooh, the lashes look good, honey. What? I'm definitely ready to eat some lunch. So I'm gonna get it together. Oh wait, see! Can we take a picture? I'm about to ask this girl to take a picture of us in our gear. Hey y'all, the skating clinic is officially over. This was so much fun and I definitely gotta go work out. If you haven't started skating, you may as well start, at least while it's nice out. So I have the creators of the skating clinic, Andrew and Danny here, and they're just gonna share a few words with you. I want you to say basically one thing you love about skating and why you started the clinic.
Hi, I'm Danny. I love teaching skating because I love seeing people who are interested in skating and get better at it really quickly. So it's a lot of fun to see them advance.
Awesome.
Hey, I'm Andrew. I'm skate instructor Andrew. And I love skating because it really gives you a wonderful sense of freedom when you go skating outdoors. I love teaching at the clinic. Tons and tons of people have been coming out to have fun and have a great time. And we love the energy and helping to teach people to become more confident skaters.
Yay! And you all are doing just that. Y'all are doing the Lord's work, honestly. So thank y'all so much for this. We will be back.
You're welcome.
Overall, C and I thoroughly enjoyed this event, and shout out to C because she found this joint on Meetup. This is by Skate DC, and it's in the DC area. So if you're in the DMV, I highly suggest that you check out their website. I will link it in the description box down below. It's free lessons, y'all, which is awesome, and they really take the time to explain things to you, especially if you are a beginner. And then even if you're not a beginner, if you're intermediate or advanced, I still think it's a great thing to check out. Huge shout out to Andrew for his hospitality. Man, he's a real MVP. We will definitely be back.
Yeah, we just got free donuts.
God bless you.
Thanks, sir. Mmm. Girl, who doesn't love a Krispy Kreme donut, honestly?
I haven't had
a
food cream in so long.
Mmm. Let me take this mask off and eat this donut. I'm about to.
Girl, I'm done. I ain't had a Krispy Kreme donut in years.
This thing is like melting in my mouth right now.
Oh my God.
So, the real tea is they opened a Krispy Kreme in our neighborhood.
I don't mess with it. You go.
I've been 3 times in the past like 3 months. I'm not a big donut person, but if I see a Krispy Kreme donut, I gotta take it.
Done.
So guess what, you guys? Now we're all done. Ooh, your girl's skin looks pretty good. I got foundation on though, but anyway. Now that we are done skating, see so we can go to brunch.
Begrudgingly.
Don't be like that.
Begrudgingly.
Because see, we like, oh, Gladys, come on, we gotta work on our budget.
We got food in the house.
We got food in the house. Okay.
We got juice.
We're gonna eat the food.
I made chili. I made, what else I made last week? Salmon.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Veggies.
The salmon that she made is bussing. Oh my god. But right now I want brunch, so. Yes, it was beautiful. Okay, so we are officially done skating for today. How you feeling, boo boo?
Great. I love skating.
No, seriously.
I really do. It's so much fun. It's so freeing, energizing. I like the little community feel. I like meeting people who like to skate. And I like how nice people are when they, like, even when you fall, people are like, oh, no, it's fine. Or when you do, like, some little turn or whatever, people are like, yay, good job. So, yes, I do enjoy skating. What about you? How you doing, sir?
Hey,
how you doing?
Oh, hello. I'm enjoying it a lot, you know. This just started with me trying to just plan a date night for C and I, and now it's become, like, our new hobby together. And that makes me very happy.
This is our thing now?
This is our thing.
At least with me, I'm more prepared for the an afternoon out. I have my whole setup. Gladys over here.
She is coming at me because I'm using a grocery bag. Okay.
I told Gladys she can walk away from me. She don't have to walk with me.
Girl, I was standing right next to you.
I'd rather you not sit next to me. I don't want people to think that I'm working with some girl who has her skates in a bag. I take this seriously. You don't.
Oh, please. Now you're a pro skater.
Now, yeah. I'm out here. I'm skating out here. I'm the, you know.
You're so full of it, girl.
I'm on the committee. What you talking about?
The committee.
Yeah. Yikes. I'm helping to plan skate night.
When is that?
October 16th. For those of you who want to come through, I won't be here, but I'm planning it.
Oh, yeah. That's Libra season, y'all.
Hey.
All the Libras about to take over.
You know what's happening.
Very soon.
It's always a good time of year. Mm-hmm. Don't you feel it in the air? You feel that fall crisp.
Yeah. Coming in. Y'all whisking through.
Coming in. Coming in strong. Coming in strong.
How old would you be, babe?
Sheesh. I am. I tell Glass I'm almost 40 years old. She needs to stop playing with me.
She's not almost 40.
I'm almost 40 years old. I'm grown, okay?
She's like a few years shy. I'm
dealing with this little baby.
Ooh, who me?
A little cradle robber. I'm legit like 40 years old.
She and I are 5 years apart, y'all. So I'm 31.
Yikes.
I know, we met when I was like 26.
Girl, you are lying.
No, deadass. I was 26 when we met. And you are 31. Isn't that funny?
All right, I'm done with this conversation. I don't want to hear no more of this. That's not for real.
That's true. Yeah, for real.
This guy about to hit me.
And now I'm turning 32 and you're turning
40.
37.
I'm not 37 already?
No.
You sure? Oh.
No, right?
I've been telling people I'm 37.
We're 5 years apart, babe, so.
Huh.
You're 36 right now.
I turn 37 later, but anyway, it doesn't matter. I've been telling people I'm 37.
I guess me as well, right?
Uh-huh. I just say 40. I ain't got time. I feel like it's easier.
It's easier.
Mm-hmm.
So if any of y'all are 40 plus, drop some life lessons for my girl.
Yeah, I need some, what's the best thing and what's the worst thing? Oh, I need some of those.
You still got a few more years, though.
Turning 40?
Yeah.
Nah, I'm already there. I gotta feel it. I gotta get prepared. You don't like change.
Oh, yeah, we know.
I don't like change. I like to prepare myself a little in advance.
Like, I feel like I'm actually sweating.
There's a little, because you worked out.
Yeah.
Surprise, surprise. First thing, first time for everything.
Don't come for me. Look at this booty. That's what he said. He said, after doing that exercise, the booty's gonna be popping.
Girl, sit down.
Look at me.
Also, Gladys, when you fell, I was, I wish I would have got it on camera. But I didn't get what Maison's fell. It was probably one of the slowest.
It was definitely a slow,
yeah. And like, I was like, is she gonna fall? And the thing is, I guess for some reason that reaction to try to help you is like gone. I was just looking at you like, this girl don't get up.
No, you.
I was like, if she don't, I'm like, what is she doing?
From
like,
my point of view, when I turned around, C's face looked like, oh my god. Like,
it was like, oh my god, she fell. Is anything broken? Now get up.
Good night.
I was a little scared though, because I'm like, this girl, first time out on pavement.
This is Nurse Philly over here.
Yeah, you know, I was about to come over there. And then also, because I was on my skates, I was like, should I run and try to go help you? And I was like, nah, I might bust my ass.
You bust your ass?
Exactly.
You can't both be down for the count.
I had to think about it. I did think about it for like 2 seconds.
All right, y'all. So we're going to get ourselves together and we'll see you at brunch.